Hey everyone, today I'll demonstrate how to enable 5G on your Japanese variant of the Samsung Galaxy S20 5G. Note that all the data on the phone will be wiped. I have a Docomo variant with me, but this method works on other variants as well, even on non-Japanese units. I'm only getting around 17 megabits per second speed on 4G. By the way, this works only on the Galaxy S20 with the Snapdragon 865 chipset. It won't work on Exynos versions of this phone. First, update your phone to the latest software. It is running Android 13 based on One UI 5.1 and the security patch from May 1st, 2023. After updating, go to About Phone, System Information, find the build number and tap it 7 times. This will enable developer options on your phone. Then go back to Settings and you'll see developer options listed at the bottom. In that section, enable OEM unlocking and USB debugging. Click OK when prompted. Then switch off your smartphone. Now connect one end of a USB cable to a Windows computer. While holding both volume buttons on your phone at the same time, connect the other end of the USB cable to it. You'll be in download mode. If you are not in download mode, try again. You might want to install Samsung USB drivers. You can release the keys when download mode appears. To unlock the bootloader, press and hold down the volume up key. Your bootloader will now be unlocked. Press the power button to continue. Set up the device as usual. You must connect to the internet while or after setting up the device. As we did earlier, go to Settings, About Phone, System Information, and tap the build number 7 times. Go back to Settings, Developer Options, and enable USB debugging. Now you will need 4 files on your computer. The Odin application file, TWRP for Samsung Galaxy S20, the VB Meta disabled file, and the modified One UI ROM with 5G support. I got this ROM file from an XDA thread, which you can find in the description. Install the Odin app on your PC. Now turn off your phone, and after connecting one end of the USB cable to your computer, hold down both volume buttons on the phone and insert the other end of the USB cable into it. If you see a light blue color and your phone is detected in Odin, click on AP and select the TWRP file. Then click on CSC and select the VB Meta disabled file. Then click the start button. After the process is done successfully, you will see pass written on a green background. The phone will power on automatically. Press the power button to skip the software warning. Then hold both the volume up button and the power button at the same time to boot into TWRP recovery. When you are in TWRP, the file manager won't be working properly and you cannot access the correct internal storage folder. To fix that, go back, click Advanced, open Terminal and type Multi-Disabler and press Enter. After the process is done, go back and select Wipe, then click on Format Data. Type yes and press enter. Then go back, click the install button, click select storage and choose internal storage. Move the downloaded Xamarin ROM file to internal storage from your computer via USB cable and select that file. Just swipe to install and you are almost done. Click reboot system and after that set up the phone as you would a brand new one. And that's it. From this point onwards, Airtel 5G will start working on your Samsung Galaxy S20 5G. If this method works on your phone, congrats, you did all the steps correctly. A like and subscribe would be appreciated. If not, just comment on where you are stuck. And either I or someone else will definitely help you. Enjoy the high speed 5G network. Thanks for watching.